posted a video in a long time. I've been meaning to, but for a little while I didn't have a camera, and I was also not feeling very motivated. Though I have to thank you, because in the period of the last few months where I haven't done a video, I've reached 1,000 subscribers. Thank you so much for that. I know, again, it's a small drop in the pond compared to, you know, big YouTube channels, but it means a lot to me that so many people would watch my content. I still have that Lord of the Rings map unfinished, thanks to those who've been requesting the third part. I will do it at some point, I promise. Today's video is going to be a little different. A while back, I did a video where I counted beans. Kind of a silly video, but this video is going to be a bit like that. But I'm going to make the perfect cup of coffee. I'm going to count out the perfect weight of beans, measure out some hot water, and make a lovely cup of coffee using this V60. I live in Bristol, in the UK, and Bristol is a very coffee-crazy city, I guess. There's a lot of independent coffee shops, and this bag of coffee is from a company called Extract Coffee. A friend of mine actually works there, and they make a lot of coffee. And this is a bag of fresh beans that I got from them, that I'm going to grind up to make my coffee from. But first, let's have a little look at the packet. So, this is called San Adolfo, from Colombia. I suppose probably from a place in Colombia called San Adolfo. It says in the cup, orange jelly tots and soft brown sugar. Now that doesn't mean that it's been flavoured like that. It means that this particular bean has been roasted in a way that accentuates its natural flavour, and they believe that the natural flavour is orange jelly dots and soft brown sugar. I don't, you know, I'm not an expert of coffee. I'm sure some of you watching this video will know a lot more than me about coffee. I'll tell you what I know. I can tell you that that when you get coffee from South America, that tends to be your traditional sort of chocolatey dark coffee. But then when you get coffee from places like Africa, Kenya, they are more fruity. They have almost they always taste like berries. I'm actually a bigger fan of coffees from that region, from East Africa, I suppose. But this coffee is still delicious. And so this company, Extract Coffee, give you a little rustle of the bag here. This company, Extract, are quite interesting. If we look on the back, we can see a little bit about their mission. Open, brew, enjoy. One simple mission: make coffee better. Better for growers, better for roasters, better for baristas, better for drinkers. We travel the world sourcing the best coffee. We roast on hand restored vintage roasters in Bristol, UK. It's an unending endeavour, and one we love. So, this is a fresh bag, and as you can see here, this is when it was roasted, on the 11th of May, 2021. We're currently at the end of June, and you're meant to drink this within 2 months of the roast date. I actually had this this bag sitting around a little while because I wanted to do this video, and so I've just been waiting to find the time. Yeah, and so this here is a sort of hole to keep it fresh, and you can see that it's sealed at the top here. Here you can see the different roasters they have that are hand restored. So this one is called Bortha, I guess. Maybe it's Bertha, but I think it's Bortha. 120 kilogram Probat, rescued from Bosnia, rebuilt in Bristol. Betty, 60 kilogram Probat, soul of the roastery, 1955, solid cast iron. This one here, I think, is called Barry, 30 kilogram Petrocini, man of mystery, built date unknown. And then James, 4 kilogram Osterk, here from the start, arrived red, now black. It's a very satisfying packet. It's got a sort of natural matte paper feel to it. And so I'm going to open it up now. Might be a bit loud, so I don't know if I'll edit it out, but we'll soon find out. So I just pulled this tab here. Okay, so that's now open. It's got a resealable pouch, so you keep your coffee beans fresh. I'll put it in case anyone is interested in this coffee. They deliver all around the place. I'll put a link to the company in the description. And so now what we're going to do is measure out 1 cup's worth of beans. My partner's away this week, so it's just me in the house. So just 1 coffee today, I think. So I'm going to take the beans out of the bag, put them down here, and then count them out into this bowl. Okay, so here we have our coffee beans, a lovely light colour. And, you know, obviously loads of people drink coffee, and I've drunk it for a long time. But there really is something lovely about taking your time with coffee. Buying nice beans, that coffee you get from those big chains, they burn the beans really dark to give it one uniform taste that's really easy to pick out. It makes a bitter coffee. I much prefer a sort of rounded coffee with slightly fruitier undertones. My preferred way of making coffee at the moment is either through an AeroPress, which I don't have at the moment, or a V60, which is just a simple filter, basically. But it's good for one person. I find it to be really good for light coffees as well. Of course, if I've got a lot of people around, I'll make a big cafetiere, but French press, I guess you might call that, depending on where you live. Okay, so you press on the scale, and I hope you can see there it says 0 grams. So we did that with the bowl on it, so that the bowl goes down to zero. It's called daring the scale. And we want 18 grams of coffee beans for me to grind up. So I'm just going to start counting them over. Well, not counting them. So that's about 2 grams we've got in there at the moment. Yeah, so I'm really sad to have not been on YouTube more in the last few months. A whole load of stuff has just been going on. It's made it difficult for me to make a video. And I've also been, as I say, a little bit lazy and unmotivated. But actually, I saw a couple of really nice comments recently from people. I hadn't checked my channel, in fact, in a couple of weeks. Well, maybe a month or so. And some people said some really nice things. So thank you very much for that. You know, it really was a bright spot to me during the difficult time of the pandemic. Being able to do these videos and share them with people. I've said before on this channel, I'm normally a theatre director. But that world is a difficult world at the moment, for obvious reasons. And it's felt nice to still be able to share things with people creatively. But just for the joy of making something and showing it to other people. Okay, we're nearly there now. Just 3 more grams we need. And then we'll have enough coffee to grind. Perfect, and lots of people make coffee perfectionists. You want from 300 grams of water exactly to 18 grams of ground coffee. So I've got my kettle here, which I hear is not a thing you have so much in America, but I've got my kettle here and we'll weigh it out into this Perspex glass jar. If you were doing this really perfectly, you would use some V60s. They come with a sort of long spouted kind of kettle that you put on the stove. That way you can measure the temperature yourself with a thermometer. I think it needs to be about 80 degrees, not boiling, because it's too hot. It burns the coffee, I think. So you would use that, and it also allows you to really slowly put the water into the V60. I don't have one of those, so I'm just going to do it straight from the kettle into here. Leave it to cool a little bit while I set up the V60. Okay, let's turn this back on. So, here we go. So, we're going to pour it in now. On the side of the jug, there's also 300 millimeters. It's gone up one now, but so I'll take that off there. Okay, so I'm going to leave that water to cool for a second while I just sort out the V60. Now, this is quite a cheap plastic one. The Ario, that's the brand. These are Ario papers actually as well. You can get reusable ones of these as well that last for a long time and are made of a sort of fabric, but I just have the paper ones. You can get these in sort of porcelain, and much nicer ones than this. This is a very basic one. And so what you do is you just fold this crease down here, just where the seam is, to make a nice cone shape. In at once, you want it to drip through nice and slowly, constantly. See, this is where when you have the long kettle with the metal spout, that you can be a little more precise with the amount of water you're adding. We'll call this the imperfect perfect coffee. It'll still taste delicious. Now with the V60, you don't get any of the what's called the crema, this white stuff on top. But if I'm honest, I think that's partly a aesthetic thing anyway. smells amazing. It's a shame you can't smell through YouTube. So soon I will be getting back to doing some of my map videos. As I've said before, they take a lot of effort, which is partly why I've been lazy, but I'm going to try and intersperse them with more videos like this that don't involve quite so much brain power. Of that drip through. It's gonna make a lovely cup of coffee. I probably could have poured the water in a little slower, but you know, life's too short. I haven't had a morning coffee yet, and it's Sunday, and really, you have to start your Sunday with a coffee. See, you can see around the edge here. Set too wide initially, that's why there's some bigger chunks of coffee in there, and then I made it thinner afterwards. It shouldn't affect it too much, but there you see it drip 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 away. Let's leave the coffee grounds there, and then I take this out and I put it in a food waste bin, and that will just decompose. If you have a garden, you can save these grounds and you can use them on the soil. They're good for soil, I think. Sometimes you can go to your local coffee shop and ask them for grounds. Put them on your tomatoes or whatever you're growing. Okay, so this is ready to take off now. Now, underneath, we have a lovely looking cup of coffee. Nice and warm, not too hot. That's the other thing, when you get those coffees from places like Starbucks, Costa, they're boiling hot and they're huge. And you know, I like caffeine, but it's really nice to enjoy a coffee, you know, to have something nice. And it's easy to do that in Bristol because there's so many local coffee places. We live just by Gloucester Road, and you know, it's got one of the longest streets of independent stores. Shops, I think, in the UK, maybe even Europe, maybe that's wrong though. Now I'm gonna give this coffee a little sip, see how it tastes, and I'll let you know. That's a really, really good cup of coffee. Delicious. It's you can taste the fruitiness to it, the richness that South American coffees have. Just the right temperature, not too strong, not too weak as well. It's really nice. So thank you for watching this video. I'm sorry it's been so long. I'll try and be a bit better. Try and post every couple of weeks or something. If you do like this, then you know, please subscribe, please comment, let me know you like it. It means a lot. And you know, I hope you're well, keeping safe and happy in these turbulent times. I'll be back hopefully in 2 weeks' time at the latest. Stay safe, look after each other.